My name is Sue from Milan.
I'm Julia, I'm from the Netherlands.
I'm also from the Netherlands.
And today we'll introduce you energy production and water purification.
Okay, so a major problem in rural places all over the world, but specifically in Africa, is that 30% of clinics do not run without electricity all the time. And out of these, 250 million patients are treated without electricity every year. So therefore, doctors need to use unreliable equipment in order to operate, and it can be very dangerous and increase infant mortality rate, for example.
As you can see in the picture, that women have to give birth in the dark when the doctors have to hold torches and stuff because they have no access to electricity.
The other major problem is sanitation and hygiene. And 1/3 of operated patients in Africa get infected due to the clinic's limited resources, them being electricity and water, the quality of water. And 80% of illnesses are linked to poor water quality. So you have people going to clinics to get help because they got sick by drinking contaminated water, and then they're being treated with also dirty water. So our solution is to produce steam in order to spin a turbine that generates electricity and distilled water as a byproduct, to improve not only the energy demand, but also electricity, but also the water quality.
So this is how the system looks like. First, we have the water source. It's not clean water, because then they pollute it. And then you use a pump in order to pump the water into a water tank. The pump will use the electricity that it generates, and we calculate that it will be less than 1% of the electricity that the system produces. Now, at the tank, the bottom of it will be made of metal and we painted it in black, so the heat will be maximum. And the other tank will be made of isolated material, so the heat won't run away to increase the efficiency. So we use reflective mirrors in order to consider the sun energy into one point of the tank, so the water will boil and produce steam in high pressure. After that, the steam will go and spin a steam turbine that will create electricity. And after that, we use a condenser to collect the steam into a distilled water jar. That will be clean water to produce the water output into the clinic. But we don't, the steam, when they come out of this, of the container, they will already be hot. So to increase the efficiency, we'll take the pump into the condenser, into the water tank. So the steam will also use the water that gets into the tank. So it becomes in a high temperature into the tank. This is the cost of the materials. You can see that the total cost is maximum $8,000, but it is a lot. But after you see, at the next day, you see that for 5 years, the payment will be $133 per month. Now, the system will produce 18 liters of clean water per hour. Now, the price of clean water in Africa is extremely high. The minimum of it is 15 cents. So you can see that per month we produce 2,800 liters of clean water. So if you calculate it, the price of the water will actually be worth $400. So it will be economically to the clinic to hold that kind of system. And this is data about the system. The energy production, we saw that clinic need to consume like 10 kilowatts hour per day. So we calculated like there's 6 hours sun or 7, depending on what day. So we put a steam turbine of 1.5 kilowatts and the clean water output 18 liters in an hour of work. The dimension of the turbine 28 on 18 centimeters. Weight of the turbine 10 kilograms. And the area of the mirror of the mirrors 28 square meters.
So the conclusion and the overall goal of our product and system is that it will provide the amount of energy necessary for clinics and just healthcare facilities in Africa to operate almost without running out of electricity. And it will also produce a large amount of clean water that will help clinics save money as well as improve sanitation. And I would just like to end by saying that although we're trying to find solutions for so many world problems, I think it's important, especially for Africa, since the population growth is so rapid, that we just stop for a second and see the world through the eyes of a child.
The purification of the water, how does it work? I mean, you create energy and then how do you purify the water? Then how do you desalinate the water?
The minimum temperature you need to purify water is around 65 degrees Celsius. So if you put to boil 100 degrees Celsius, the steam will already with no bacteria and
you condense the steam?
Yes, and then it has a cold surface and then it becomes water back.
It's not desalination, it's purification. It's not desalination. Then you have to add minerals to the water.
Yeah,
but we saw that other uses of clean water, not only for drinking, but also for medical issues like cleaning material, equipment and stuff.
It can be used in like surgery to prevent bleeding, external and internal bleeding.
When the skin is open during a surgery, the doctor uses clean water because they want it to be as they don't want the bacteria to affect the surgery or hurt the patient.
Your title was like electricity and water, and you focused only on the water production. How much electricity is generated besides the water? You said 18 liters per hour. And how much electricity?
Around 12 kilowatts per day. That's the amount of energy they need.
That means you'll do operations only during the day?
Yes.
And hours.
Then you need storage for nighttime and for overcast, for cloudy days.
Yes, but our main goal is not to use batteries and stuff because when the system works, this is the time we can give them the
water storage, distilled water storage.
No, it will be connected to our water, you know, to the grid of the water, you know, we can use a tube in order to give them the water.
Still, if they cloudy day, you have no water, no distilled water.
Yes, but
right, sometimes the cloud may stay for many days.
Yes, so that's why we aim for places, you know, like Africa, when most of the times have sun, but still, in cloudy days, it will be a problem.
So judges, can you please raise your voices, because you can't hear you.
You may have to add storage.
Yes.
Water storage, yes. This will change a little bit the economics. Yes,
because if you saw the system, it will came to a container, so when it's cloudy, we can close the container and just, you know.
Okay, you have to calculate for how long can you store water.
Yes.
Maybe you can use rainwater in those places.
I would add that you said that the source of your water is unclean. It comes from rivers or water sources in the area.
Yes.
And do you plan to just use those water directly into the pipeline that you're building?
Yes.
Do you not see anything that needs to be done with those water before doing that?
No.
What kind of risks might come with unclean water, aside from not being able to drink it? Technically.
It will, you know, get a lot of concentration of the... once in a while you can open it and clean it.
You have to put filters.
Yes.
Which, again, changes
the...
Filter will
be built in the pump.
Mm-hmm. And also, you might have corrosion in the pipes that needs to be treated.
Thank you.